There's breaking news on Victoria's storm chaos, with police revealing that a man has been killed after his car was swept away in a creek in South Gippsland. The wild weather blasted the state for 24 hours, leaving Traralgon on flood alert, homes in Dandenong crushed, and emergency crews stretched to the limit.
It's the biggest SES call-out in Victorian history. Hundreds of thousands of people affected statewide. Winds up to 120 kilometres an hour. Record rains of up to 300 millimetres in 24 hours. 240,000 people left without power.
Many people would have woken up this morning and seen absolute carnage out there.
In Alinda, a woman was injured and her nine-year-old son had to be rescued when a tree fell on their home.
The house literally got cut in half by this tree.
Surrounding roads were blocked, so police had to walk in 1.5 kilometres.
Given the circumstances of a lady and son trapped in the house, you don't even really consider it. Someone needs to get there.
The mother was found with head injuries downstairs, separated from her little boy trapped upstairs and very calm.
The son was a trooper though. He was, when I found him, he was on his bed reading a book.
A responding paramedic was shaken but lucky to escape injury when a tree fell on a vehicle. An SES van too was crushed. The SES was called to 800 damaged homes, mainly in the Dandenongs. Huge toppling trees taking a huge toll.
Half an hour later, then I heard the big fella, this one here on the roof. Yep.
After record rainfall in Gippsland, about a dozen people were caught in cars engulfed in water. Late today, police confirmed a man in his 60s died when his car was found partly submerged at Woodside, east of Wilson's Promontory.
Oh my God, literally a mate, that's so bad.
This stark warning from authorities.
We can't emphasise enough to never drive through floodwaters. It will be the last decision you possibly make.
The SES had 6,000 calls for help statewide. This, the call-out map earlier today. Inner Melbourne was not spared. The Altona Pier was swept ashore. Dozens of boats were damaged. The rare sight of surfers in the bay. 24 hours of ferocity with repercussions for months. Nick McCallum, 7 News.
Melbourne's outer east is one of the hardest hit areas. Melina Saris is in Montrose this evening. And Melina, so many homes have been crushed by trees, it's incredible no one was killed there.
Mitch, several people were taken to hospital, but no one was killed or even badly injured. Quite remarkable when you see the damage to house after house. Of those 6,000 calls for help, the busiest areas were the outer east and the southeastern suburbs of Melbourne. 800 of those calls were for damaged buildings like houses and businesses. Paul Dowsley has spent the day in Alinda speaking to some of the victims out there.
As the SES walked into this Alinda house, it seemed all was calm, but a look to the right revealed the horrifying result of a wild night.
Split it in half, just absolute carnage.
A tree smashed through the 80-year-old resident's bedroom around 3 a.m, sending her 3 metres down under the house.
She has a disability with... She has trouble with sight, so it would have been very scary.
She was rescued 8 hours later after it's believed a neighbour found her.
You've had a rough morning.
Right. You haven't had a good day, you're right.
How would you describe what happened?
Oh, well, I was in bed 1 minute and under the house the next.
At ground level, the devastation is incredible, thanks to a tree which was probably 100 metres tall. What's also incredible is that despite her fall, the resident was barely injured.
Oh, there's some very lucky, blessed people.
The peak of the storm swept through the Dandenongs around 4 a.m, smashing Alinda, Sassafras, Kalorama and surrounds.
It looks like it's out of a movie. It's like an apocalypse.
The McLaughlin family was cut off in Sassafras, their cars crushed under their carport, plus no power, no phone and no way out, including on the road outside their house. You could feel the trees coming down?
Oh yeah, you could feel the house. There was a tremor. and you could, the house could shake.
You can actually hear it coming through the air and then the impact on the ground, and we could hear that all night.
This gives you a sense of the size of some of the massive gums that fell. This root ball dwarfs me, but luckily this one fell just onto a road and power lines and not any cars or houses. Residents drove around fallen trees and under them as emergency crews tried to clear critical roads. Many locals stepped up with their own equipment. Chris Field volunteered his tools and skills.
I'm just the arborist who couldn't get to work in Springvale today, so, but I found my work up here, so I'm happy to have it at the community.
Paul Dowsley, 7 News.
And Traralgon is on edge tonight after hundreds of homes were evacuated. Cassie Zervos is there this evening, and Cassie, the floodwaters are still rising.
Well, Mitch, residents across the region are being urged to brace for more major flooding. Rivers and creeks continue to rise after a terrifying night of intense rain and howling wind. An underground hotel car park flooded in just 15 minutes. The water lifting up cars right to the roof. Upstairs, guests told to get out. Traralgon Creek becomes a raging river, trapping drivers. Saved by chopper crews. More than 200 families evacuated in a race against the rising water, with only time to grab what is most precious. Some managed to get out in time before torrents of water inundated streets.
And your stepdaughter's inside as well now?
Yeah, I've got to go and grab a carrier. So it's, she wouldn't be able to walk through. It's pretty high up. It's like probably up to my waist nearly.
I knew it was going to get high, but I didn't think it was going to get this high this quick. And I've been at my place for over 30 years and I've seen it this high before, but it looks like it's going to get higher again.
Others needed more help carried by emergency crews to avoid this, the unknown, below the muddy water.
About 6 o'clock in the morning, it'd come up to our back veranda and then it just rose probably up to our knees almost inside.
We haven't had floods like this for quite a period of time.
So sad. The oval is not even an oval anymore. The shipping container's moved.
The town was hit by winds of more than 100 kilometres an hour and more than 60 millimetres of rain.
Don't drive into floodwater. Don't go into floodwater on foot.
Heartbreak in Walhalla, the historic gold mining town hit by massive mudslides.
I was woken when the power went off, but also by hearing huge boulders thumping down the creek.
A landslip has occurred, which has taken out part of the blacksmith shop.
More than 5 hours after the severe rainfall and flash flooding, SES crews continue to go door to door, rescuing people trapped in their homes, just like this gentleman here.
Yeah, nice and slow. Yep, nice and slow. Good job.
The waters continue to rise in Traralgon, with parts of Gippsland now on a major flood watch. It's the last thing these towns need after their night from hell. Cassie Zervos, 7 News.
The storm was so fierce that hundreds of homes were damaged in the Yarra Ranges. Tegan Doling joins us now. And Tegan, there were almost 1,000 calls for help in Lilydale alone.
Well, Mitch, the Yarra Ranges was one of the worst hit spots. Those really strong winds started to come through late yesterday afternoon and it's caused an enormous amount of damage because there's trees down everywhere and it's leaving residents with a huge clean-up ahead.
A family's trampoline, now a mangled mess, picked up and flung metres into the air. Residents know that living on the outskirts of Melbourne's eastern suburbs, surrounded by giant trees, comes with a risk. But they say this storm was something else.
Oh, look, the noise was incredible. It was constant and it was just so loud. You could just hear trees falling everywhere. You could hear tin flying. And it was just continuous all night, did not let up.
This ute belongs to Jackie Warren's son, a second-year apprentice, now in need of another way to get to work. They've never seen a storm like this before.
Not in the 10 years that we've been here, and just chatting to the neighbours, they can't remember anything like it either, so...
Roger Flint has lived in Lilydale for 45 years.
Well, we didn't get any sleep, obviously. I don't think any of the neighbours got any sleep.
and all I could hear was the trees falling.
There were roadblocks all over the Dandenongs, Yarra Valley and outer eastern suburbs.
It was terrifying last night. No one's been to bed. We've just sat up all night. We just kept checking out the window, crack, crack, and then we're like, oh my God.
If this tree had fallen the other way, this Croydon resident says he would have been killed.
Unbelievable. If I turn other side, I'll die.
Wow.
No more life.
The Vakolchek family is facing a massive clean-up. Their Lilydale backyard a mess after a giant pine tree and two gums narrowly missed their house.
We always wondered if it was going to come down and, yep, they got it this time.
The girls now in need of a new trampoline.
We only had to use it a few times, so now we're going to have to get a new one. Yeah.
Tegan Dolling, 7 News.
Towns around Daylesford have been cut off as the storm brought down trees across dozens of roads. The emergency effort to help residents whose homes were damaged was hampered by phone and internet services going down with the power.
This storm-battered house at Tilden made it through the night but was torn open this morning. Relentlessly hammered by screaming winds and flooding rain.
Shrieking, screaming metal. Just the whole house sounded like it was being ripped apart and screaming.
Property owner Christine Taylor is a 30-year volunteer with the Wood End SES and was rescued by her fellow volunteers.
I'm absolutely lucky that I'm okay. My cats are in the car. I'm sad about my pony if he's not okay. Sorry.
Her neighbour's home was also damaged. 700 kilogram water tanks ripped up and flung away. At around 3 o'clock this morning, Darren Parnas was forced to patch up his family home after a large tree tore through a wall.
It just sounded like a Hercules helicopter across. Lost about 11 trees, 12 trees all up. 150-year-old pine cypress out there, cut in half.
Trees fell in such vast numbers that the town of Trentham was completely shut off. Every road into town was blocked. Local SES units scrambled to more than 265 jobs around Trentham, Tilden and Wood End. One of the complications in responding to this emergency has been a lack of phone and internet coverage. At times, it's just been impossible for people to make contact over the phone. The pace at being able to regain essential services slowed by the caution needed over the prospect of even more falling trees. Cameron Bowe, 7 News.
There are many Victorians in the dark tonight, knocked off the power grid when wind and trees pulled power lines from the sky. Blake Johnson, it could be days before many can turn the lights back on.
And it's a real concern, Pete. One of the state's major electricity providers says some customers might not be back online until the weekend. That relentless wind overnight caused problems right around the state on a scale repair crews rarely see. Tonight, those same repair crews are out in the elements, repairing nature's damage.
One by one, falling trees yanked thousands of homes off the grid. Hardest hit, east of Melbourne. Most of the 240,000 properties that lost power are out that way.
The road is covered, the power lines are down, the internet's down. To be honest, we're probably the last on the list with the, you know, with the power company, and we have to wait our turn with the SES. So we probably won't even be able to leave our street for 24 hours. Everyone's scrambling for generators because it might be a while till we get power as well.
But generators must not connect to a home's wiring. It's dangerous and illegal.
If you're using the generator, make sure you use it outside and use an extension cord to connect it to the appliances that you're running.
Even this cement power pole in Healesville couldn't hold up.
There's no power whatsoever. There's no phone reception. There's no internet. There's no work being done. Sorry, boss.
Without reception, QR code check-ins stopped working. The queue into Coles growing.
Making arrangements now to get the torches and the candles ready for tonight.
Many homes could be without power until Sunday.
This is the worst storm to impact our network in over 40 years.
If you lose power, turn off appliances you were using. You might not be there when the power comes back, and that's a fire risk. Keep at least 8 metres from fallen power lines.
Standing next to power lines can be fatal. The power can jump.
Blake Johnson, 7 News.
And authorities have issued a warning for Victorians to be extra careful around trees over the next few weeks. The combination of strong southeasterly winds and soaking rain could have made some more vulnerable to falling. Large trees can come down with no warning at any time. Jane Bunn joins us now. And Jane, this widespread system certainly delivered a wallop.
It did indeed, Mitch. It's not unusual for this type of weather pattern to develop at this time of year. But where this one tracked left Victoria right in the firing line.
We can thank a huge low sitting over New South Wales for our wild night. It played both sides of the weather spectrum, pulling cold air up from Antarctica while at the same time sucking moisture down from the tropics. The result? Strong winds and heavy rain across a wide area of Victoria. And not just for a short time, which usually happens when we get hit by a cold front. This east coast low meant the onslaught was relentless. More than 300 millimetres falling at Mount Baulbal, setting a new 24-hour record. Puckapunyal copped winds of just under 120 kilometres an hour, over 100 k's an hour on Port Phillip Bay. Thankfully, these intense lows only happen a few times a year. This time around, Victoria has really ended up at the wrong end of the system. While it's brought a bumper start to the snow season in New South Wales, most Victorian Alps had rain and lots of it.
The low has now weakened, but it's not over yet. Another 30 to 80 millimetres of rain is likely over southern Gippsland on Friday night and Saturday. So they have a 24-hour reprieve, but then it comes back.
There have been more than 6,000 calls for help in Victoria's wild weather emergency, and crews are gearing up for another busy night. SES Deputy Chief Dave Baker joins us now. And Dave, it's been one of the most intense days in SES history.
Absolutely, Peter. The busiest 24-hour period in Vic SES history as our crews and our partner agency crews work together to try and get through the storm damage impacts through Central Highlands, the Dandenongs and elevated parts of metropolitan Melbourne, whilst at the same time we have crews working with communities and partner agencies in Gippsland to deal with the flooding impacts and the risks down there.
Parts of Victoria are being warned to brace for flooding to escalate over coming days. What's your message to people at home?
Thanks, Peter. Three clear messages for people at home with the floodwaters. Never drive in floodwaters. And any circumstances. Importantly, for tonight, people in the storm impacted areas and the flood risk areas, if you don't need to be on the road, stay at home where it's safe and warm. And finally, despite COVID restrictions, if you do need to relocate due to emergency impact, you are entitled to do so and go to a safer place.
SES Deputy Chief Dave Baker, thanks for your time tonight.
Thanks, Peter.